Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play New Origin 3 on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install New Origin 3 and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play New Origin 3. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, to start we have to launch our favorite web browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to that URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because I provided a link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We ended up there on the website of Usitility, in which we include a detailed information on the best way to download and install New Origin 3 on computer. We search down a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we get to the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will launch to enjoy the game New Origin 3 on the PC. It is now obvious that we have some advantages of using this emulator. So we are ready to start downloading the New Origin 3 by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It is a file to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, then we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the computer. We clicked yes. I minimized the internet browser to find the installer considerably better. The installation software is very simple to use. It contains two possibilities, install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path truly does. We simply click on it. And therefore we note that we end up with here the path in which the emulator can be placed. If we want to vary this folder we are required to click on this browse button, and now we select another directory and set up the emulator wherever we like. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. Then, I click on back. Therefore I simply click install. Fantastic. The setup begins and it's going to progress along with the download of these MB that happens to be shown on that screen. After you download it, it may be a bit more or less MB. The data transfer rate can be faster or slower, subject to your connection and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. Now they are working very fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator happens to be started instantly. As you can discover, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up then when it reaches the finish, the emulator is started for the very first time. Indeed the emulator was already started, here for the very first time. Before we keep going, as you can see now, it has made two app icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is going to be the only one we are considering. Every time we choose to run New Origin 3 on the desktop or laptop, we twice mouse click on this software icon and consequently start the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi-Instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved Multi-Instance Manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we perform the following step, that is a must-have, and which is to access the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is started. At this point we need to log on. So now as soon as we're there, we must definitely perform the following step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. Therefore we simply click on Sign In. Presently it shows checking info. It could from time to time get stopped at checking info, additionally it does not advance. In this case, you could attempt to log in after a number of hours and it may probably be solved. At this time we're going to provide our username and password. The email must be a Gmail email address as well as its associated password. For instance you may use the exact same email address you are using currently in your own YouTube account. Then I will insert my information and I'll return immediately after I have accomplished it. Voila, details typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We should say yes to them all simply by hitting, I agree. Following that, it makes it possible to save to the Google Cloud. You could keep it selected and it will build a backup of your files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you can utilize that option if you prefer. We click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched automatically and instantly. To set up the video game, we need to browse the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on that icon designated green colored. At present that we are watching the desktop of this Android emulator, we notice that we have now here the install application option. We click or double click on that button. Listed here we have got the game app. Why don't we mouse click right here on the install button that I am just presenting now in green color. That click will commence the software installation. At this point it would install the game app, it can take a bit of time or it could possibly be extremely fast. This all depends on the connection to the internet. This has by then finished installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by pressing this specific button I'm showing in green, in order to start New Origin 3 for the very first time. You are by then on the emulator desktop, and so we are preparing to click this brand new New Origin 3 software icon which was generated. Your video game is started for the first time on your device. So there we get it, I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the volume level of this emulator. This is right here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we could activate the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This one is actually the first one, we just click on that software icon that I am designating in green color. Thus the monitor is maximized, offering one border on top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. Granted that we wish to run the video game using all the screen, we hit this game icon. And thus we would likely presently be experiencing the Android game in 100% screen mode. To quit the complete screen functionality, push the F11 key. And we might now end up being in standard display mode. At present, I am choosing to demonstrate you the computer keyboard mapping and that is definitely very enjoyable. That step we may be capable to utilize the video game more effortlessly. The very first task is to press this computer keyboard icon. It's now time to get the required controls. I can leave the standard settings, though if you prefer to modify that, you can also do it with no problem. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our own language. In some cases it occurs that your emulator is launched in the improper language, such as, in Mandarin. And as a consequence to place it in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus there inside of additional controls, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can select the language we need, German, Japanese, etc. When the language is selected, we would save, the emulator will reboot, as well as the game application, the next time we run it, will as well be in the specified language. So now, there's another information that we will need to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Google Mail telling you that a different machine has been linked to our own Google account. It is going to ask us if we're the people who have associated with that electronic device. Indeed, we must not get worried, as the emulator is behaving like an Google Android smartphone or tablet. So you can find which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Let's go here to the model choice. And right here we realize that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for our training. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was interesting. In that case, offer it a great like, subscribe to the channel, and I will be happy to answer all your remarks, requests or ideas, leave them in the comment field down below. You also can comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams on occasion, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of these instructional videos that are appearing on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the upcoming online videos. Bye.